You're traveling through another dimension. A dimension not only of sight and sound, but of mind. A journey into a wondrous land whose boundaries are that of imagination. That's the signpost up ahead. Your next stop, the Twilight Zone.
So, how is it today?
It's pretty good. I came across this one girl, and she was asking about, you know, Jesus and everything, but I was just nervous and scared, and I just didn't know what to say.
I didn't talk to her. Well, I know, like, it's hard sometimes. I get scared, but can I, like, tell you something? Like, I've been studying a lot in Romans, actually. And the other day, I came across something that was really cool, and it just convicted me a lot. So, like, I don't know. It gave me a little boldness of kind of, like, to help me witness. So,
okay.
It's Paul. You know how he was kind of a sinner and all this stuff, and then God changed him, and he witnessed and he did all this crazy stuff. But he was a Jew and not, he didn't like the Gentiles and all that. But here it's like Romans, it's the first chapter, verse 14, and it says, I'm a debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the unwise. And it just like hit me because he's like, he hated the Gentiles, like he was raised that way. But he knew like he had something that was just so important. He owed it to those people to share it to, like to anybody he met, he owed it to them. It was just that important. And so, like, we're the same way. We have something that's that important. We owe it to those people to share it, no matter how uncomfortable it makes us. Like, we owe it to them.
Yeah.
You're
probably right.
It's just scary.
It's getting light.
I'm gonna go to bed.
Good night.
Good night.
Thank you.
Rachel? Are you smoking?
Yeah. Once it's here.
What is going on in this place? Great. And now they've started worship without me.
We can do is just hope that she finds Jesus by herself.
What? Time to get up. Angel, I had the craziest dream. I gotta go witness that girl today. You were right.